Why Kanban? A presentation for the South Florida Agile Association at Nova Southeastern University on November 3rd, 2015. Hi, my name is Eugenio Alvarez. I am a South Florida software development professional focusing on agile software development since 2013. Introduction. Economic forces are driving companies to develop software faster to gain competitive advantage. The software development community has found that agile development can address the competitive need for speed. The Lean Kanban method adds an agility framework for software development that is simple, efficient, with the capacity to improve quality. Kanban's elevator pitch. For companies with software development teams who are dissatisfied with speed, quality of software development, the Lean Kanban method is a new option to improve responsiveness. Unlike Scrum, it does not require hiring new roles. It's an inexpensive method to improve business value. Questions. Why Kanban? Challenges in moving to Kanban. How can Kanban transform a team? How were obstacles tackled? What were the benefits realized? Recommendations. Why Kanban? Working at a rapidly growing software development company created a need to organize software developers for productivity. We found as we added more developers, the productivity dropped until we came up with an organizational framework. And this is how we found Kanban. Like they say, necessity is the mother of invention. Or as Master Yoda would say, do or do not, there is no try. Looking at the Scrum Alliance report from June 2013, the question is posed, what agile approach is your organization using? Select all that apply. We notice that Kanban is being used 15% of the time. We move forward. Same Scrum Alliance survey from July 2015. We see that the combination and use of Kanban has increased from 15% to 43%. Many organizations are mixing and matching approaches and frameworks. You see combinations of Scrum, Waterfall, Kanban, and Lean. One of these approaches, dubbed Scrumban, which is a combination of Scrum and Kanban, coined by Corey Lattus, you see there's a spectrum where you have a focus on Scrum with a little bit of Kanban methods, all the way to mostly Kanban with some of the practices being Scrum. We want to step back a little bit and compare software development frameworks versus methodology. A software development framework is an incomplete set of practices needed for software construction. Gaps are filled with additional methods or tools to make a working methodology. So you can say, for example, that Scrum is a framework because it doesn't specify everything. Kanban is also, you could also categorize it as a framework, as you can mix and match them together. This is compared to a software development methodology, which includes a full set of practices and tools needed for software construction. It's common in that scenario to omit parts of the full methodology that are not appropriate for a given environment. What we find is the agile methods are becoming more adaptive and less prescriptive. What we have here is from the book Kanban and Scrum, Making the Most of Both. And we have here counts of roles, activities and artifacts. We start from the left-hand side, RUP, Rational Unified Process, with over 120. Then we proceed to go down to XP, Extreme Programming, Scrum, and finally Kanban. And what's happening is the frameworks are getting smaller and more adaptive because they're not specifying less. Here we formally introduce the Lean Kanban method, a software development agility framework. Kanban originates from Japanese term where kan means visual and ban means card or board. Influenced by lean manufacturing, the Toyota production system, and Eliyahu's Go-Rat's theory of constraints, developed by David J. Anderson. Kanban helps agile be more agile, accelerating time to market, more easily managing changing priorities, better aligning IT and business objectives, increasing productivity, enhancing software quality, and project visibility. Reasons for Kanban adoption include other methods didn't make sense. It's an evolutionary step for some agile teams to increase their agility. the need or ability for daily task rescheduling was so important that the method of Kanban was adopted. Also, organizational resistance. Kanban is a method that can be adopted from the bottom up without top-level managerial assistance. And in some organizations, when there's resistance to agile methods that includes restructuring development, this is the only way to go. Let's start by discussing some important concepts. These are include flow, pull, and Kaizen. What is flow? Flow here is termed from the assembly line, generating a cadence. In the case here, this is Henry Ford and the definition of flow lines. This is different from another term for flow, which is more like a mental state from Mihai Csikszentmihalyi. What is pull? In this case, pull means pulling inventory. In the case like a grocery store, we see here an example of a grocery store where you pull inventory and the next it just gets replenished. This is an important concept in lean methods. What is Kaizen? Kaizen is a Chinese-Japanese word for improvement. In the case here, we're looking at that diagram, plan, do, check, act, which is also a part of the renewal process for continuously improving and iterating over to make an improvement in processes, which is one of the core concepts in lean and Kanban method. So we have the conceptual overview, we have flow, we have pull, and we have Kaizen. We start by the introduction of the Kanban method as quoted from Mr. Anderson's book. Mr. Anderson describes Kanban with a capital K as the evolutionary change method that utilizes Kanban small k pull systems, visualization, and other tools to catalyze the introduction of lean ideas into technology development and IT operations. We have the Kanban method, consisting of guiding principles and core practices. Kanban method principles include: start with what you know, agree to pursue evolutionary change, initially respect roles, responsibilities, and job titles, encourage acts of leadership at all levels. Kanban method practices include visualization, limiting work in progress, WIP, managing flow, making policies explicit, implementing feedback loops, improving collaboratively, evolving experimentally using models and scientific methods. Visualization include Kanban board and other visual methods. Limiting work in progress reduces the amount of multitasking so that they can focus on getting things done versus starting on things. Here's a quote from Eliyahu Gorath's Critical Chain. And this diagram shows you what happens as you increase the number of work items if you have large work in progress amounts. Managing flow with cumulative flow diagrams so you can visually see what's going on and measuring them. Making policies explicit, specifying board rules, identifying what are the steps in the process. The actual board itself, by specifying the swim lanes, is setting of rules in the order in which you do things. Implementing feedback loops include daily stand-up meetings, weekly replenishment meetings, and monthly operational review meetings. Improving and evolving collaboratively, creating experiments and trying different things, using the scientific method to improve. Scrum, Kanban, or Scrumban, which are the methods you want to consider? Do you have separate teams for new development and maintenance? That's the case. It's a very common pattern to have the Kanban method being used on the maintenance team while the new development is being done with Scrum or some Scrumban. Do you have enough people for a cross-functional Scrum team? If you don't have enough people, you might want to consider Kanban as the method, preferred method for you. Do you have a team that can focus in 2 to 4 week intervals with minimal interruption? This is the classic Scrum time box. If you cannot do that, you might want to consider Kanban, which is more focused on daily reprioritization as necessary. And then finally, you have, is your company culture against agile? So what happens is, for example, in Scrum adoptions, you have the new roles, and it's not unusual to have a situation where management's against additional resources. If that's the case, start with Kanban. So we have here a David Letterman style top 10 signs. Your Kanban is not working. Start off with number 10. We can't get started until we get everything right. So this is counter to one of the most basic tenets of the Kanban method. Start where you are, and then you strive to improve. Number 9, missing work on the board. So what happens is actual things are being done. They're not represented in the board at all. Not representing, number 8, not representing the actual items that are being worked on. So it's misrepresenting the actual status of the items. Number 7, not updating the boards daily. What happens is you have your stand-up, and that's the indicator. You always have a state where your board is actually up to date. Number 6, tasks are not flowing. Creating tasks that take too many days. The idea for the board is to have task items that are no more than a week, usually 3 days, so that you have things flowing on the board. Number 5, no visualization, no workflow. What happens is if you don't see, the team cannot see what's going on, and they don't get motivated from knowing that things are actually working. Number 4, not knowing what to do exactly. This is policies, not having specific explicit rules. Number 3, lack of agile engineering practices. It's common, so for example, that these frameworks specify an outline of the method, but don't go into the details of the agile engineering practices. So it's common without having these practices, any of these agile methods won't work for you. Number 2, limiting work in progress. It's a very common scenario. We have a developer or a manager saying, hey, great, you're working on 5 items at once. I'm going to get so much stuff done. The focus of Kanban is finishing, not starting multiple things. And then finally, Kaizen, which is a self-improvement. So you're doing these things on the board, and you're not reviewing the board and changing it to optimize to your system. What happens is every environment is different, and Kaizen is necessary in order for you to be able to improve. Conclusion. Kanban provides an agile framework that works along other software development methods or by itself. Kanban's ease of implementation allows for its deployment in a wide variety of environments. Kanban is a method that can be incorporated into all aspects of IT, including portfolio management, software development, and operations. I want to say thank you to the Agile Association for hosting the meeting and our sponsors for this meeting, Ultimate Software and Nova Southeastern University. Thank you for watching this video.